All right, Felix, and anybody else that's concerned has had to replace the air blow hoses for the tire machine here. As you can see, these old hoses, they just, they just broke. They just dry rotted out. They're probably about 18, 19 years old. These are the new hoses, trimmed off ends. And this is where they go underneath. And these are just the push-in ends. So nothing much wondrous about it, except getting them out. You gotta get all four of them out of there. So these fittings had to come off because the other pieces were so dry rotted you couldn't pull them out. And you had to take it all out and get a little tiny screwdriver in there and dig them out. These type of ends without the plastic on them, they came out just fine. But these with the plastic on it, man, everything's stuck in there. So it's all done now. And I even noticed that the factory originally routed these way too long and in a bad spot. They were constantly hitting these bolts down here. Every time it turned the plate, if you had a small rim on it and didn't expand these clamps all the way. And all these hoses do is they blow air up into the tire to help seat the tire on the bead. You know, it gives it a real big shot of air inside the tire. Kind of like Felix said, you know, put some gasoline in there and light it up. Well, that's not really safe and you want it to work properly. So anyway, that was my little project here, and this is a quick way 502 tire machine, which I think they're already obsolete, even though I bought this thing brand new. Like I said, 18-19 years ago, and really it saw a fair amount of use, but you know, for a little five bay shop, it really didn't. Specialize in tires. It was more of a courtesy that I offered to the customers that were my regular customers, that I would provide them with tires. And you know, the money you make on tires isn't too bad, unless you got a warranty a bunch of them if you get the wrong supplier. But anyway, there it is, another fix that got done. And there's the old crappy stuff. And I think this company charged me $73, that included shipping, which was nothing, it was a little envelope, for four of these hoses, which is a lot of money for these hoses, but, you know, they specialize in equipment. And I've gotten the numbers off of the hose itself, and I'm sure I can cross-reference something, but like I said, you know, having this hose laying around, even if I find any right now, this hose will probably last another 18 years, and by that time, I'm sure I'll be dead. So, you know, I don't care, whoever gets the machine next can worry about it, but at least I got the numbers written down in case one of them does break. But anyway, that's the latest little project here. Nothing new to really report on. The world's still crazy as shit, and I don't care about hashtag Me Too or anybody else's horse shit they're doing out there. I'm too busy worrying about my own life. So let all the feminists, SJWs, and PC, and whatever the fuck else is out there causing all kinds of trouble, let them have fun. As long as they keep me the fuck out of it, I'm going to continue doing what I do, which is riding and going to bars where people like that don't go. They'd never have the balls to come in there. And if they did, it'd be a big mistake on their part. Even though I'm, you know, well, I'll be 61 years old, I still have a fair amount of kick-ass left in me. So, plus I always have at least five weapons on me. So, yeah, it's going to be a losing battle, but, you know, realistically, they're going to go for easier targets, and I don't really care. You know, if they want to push the issue, well, then that's up to them, and I won't be the only person in the place that's going to going to throw down with them. Actually, I'm probably the last guy that will. Anyway, all right, that's it, guys. It's just reporting from the home front here in Florida. It's about 72 degrees today. It has been warming up, so I'm starting to watch the plants to see if they start sprouting any new growth. And then, I'll start doing a little bit of gardening again. And, I'll do a quick update here. I did get done with the raised garden bed that I had in the back there that I started, a month ago? And I did get it done, so that just the plants need to be put in, and I did that, mulched up a bunch of the stuff that I took off, so it's all painted up. The concrete's dried up real nice, and that mulch was from that tree over there. That limb was falling down on my house, and I cut it up and just mulched up all the crap. So these plants here, these were the lauripedlums from up front. So I think, let's see if they take off. If they don't, no big deal. But right now, I think in Florida, this might be the perfect time to get everything done. I think it came out pretty good. Looks nice. I mean, for a worn out old man, this was fairly simple to do, and taking my time. So, got to get a few plants for the long portion of it, and then replace a couple out front where I picked those out of the hedge. And that's it, man. See, always something to keep a man busy. And you don't need any woman with a honey-do list telling you what to do and when to do it. And I do this stuff when I feel like it, when I'm able to do it. Life's good, man. Life's good. All right. Everybody have a good day, man. I hope you guys start warming up north and overseas in Europe and everything. And I know the Aussies, they're having their summer right now, so they're probably playing in the water or doing something, other ridiculous things. Not sure what Aussies do, play with a ruse or something like that. So, we get to play with gators and cranes. And by the way, speaking of cranes, the cranes finally kicked the baby out, and they're very aggressive with the baby, chasing it away. Man, it is wild. Baby's almost, run into the highway a couple times, but they want the baby gone. They want it on its own, and they're not fucking around. I mean, that's nature taking its course. Animals are a hell of a lot smarter than we are. That baby's been taught how to feed, where to get food, how to fly, and it's grown up and they want it gone. They just get out, and they're pretty damn mean about it. If I can catch it on film, I will one of these days. But I tell you what, those two parents are like, "Nah, you're getting out of the house, buddy," and they're not fucking around. I mean, they're getting nasty about it. So anyway, that's it. Yeah, that's all I got, man. All right, everybody, be